In this video, we're going to talk about the new features of the XViz Gantt chart. The first point we're going to cover is support for ragged hierarchies. So you can see that I have a blank row here based on this ragged hierarchy. If we simply click on the graph and go to the formatting options, we can go to the chart options and turn on hide blank. And now those blank levels of the hierarchy are now gone. There is also fiscal year support. We can change the start month of our fiscal year. So if we change it to May, for instance, we can see that Q1 now starts in May. And we even have the option to change the date format directly. We can see we're set to month, month, day, day, year, year. We can change this to any assortment of date combinations, such as day, day, month, month, year, year. Finally, we also have the option to display totals, which is going to show a total row on top of all of our parent and child nodes. We can see that right there with the overall result, and it sums our plan duration column. On top of this, we can set the default aggregation for this numerical column. If we come down to the number formatting, we'll have an option for plan duration aggregation. Let's change that to average, for example, and we'll see how that now shows the average of all of the children of this task. We can also set up conditional formatting for this Gantt chart with this pencil icon. Simply click on it. We'll be in the conditional formatting options. Let's add a rule here. We are able to set conditional formatting for the parent or child levels or both. Let's set ours to parent. We're going to apply this to progress and data grid. We have the option to apply the conditional formatting to the track, fill, or both. We'll set it to track. We are going to add a column name. We will add our task name. Let's add a rule here. If our plan duration is greater than or equal to 7. We want to color it red. Let's go ahead and click save. We'll see that conditional formatting applied to parent nodes where that plan duration is greater than or equal to 7. And we also see that it affects the task name as well as the track as we specified. From this advanced editor, we can also add reference lines. So let's add a new reference line here. We can add a reference line for today. Let's actually add a custom date. Let's add a reference line for March 31st, since that will show in our data. We can give this a name. Let's call this progress check. And let's scroll down and click save. And we now see this reference line showing up on our Gantt chart. We even have the option to add multiple reference lines if we need to. Now let's look at the web URLs option. We can add a web URL. Let's click on add new URL. So we're going to display the column URL based on field URL. And instead of showing the full URL in this column here, let's change it to icon and click apply. And now if we click on the dropdown for any of these parent nodes, we'll see that these child nodes now have this URL icon that will link directly to an external web page. Also in the advanced editor, we can click on zoom levels. We can set up a custom zoom level for our Gantt chart. Let's turn that on. Let's change that to 7 days for our case. Click save. We will now see that our zoom level will be set to 7 days. Let's exit the advanced editor and let's go to the formatting options. Let's go down until we see data labels. Let's turn those on. We can apply horizontal and vertical offsets to set our data labels in the correct position. We can change our alignment to center or left. Let's change it to left. Let's set a negative horizontal offset so that they display to the left of our progress bar. So now we see those data labels displayed there. You also have the ability to add connector lines to your Gantt chart. Coming over to this new tab where we have connector lines already set up, you'll be able to see that we are able to show dependencies between tasks within this Gantt chart. These are some of the new features added to the XViz Gantt chart.